Hey, hey, welcome back to the Conversion Clinic. In this video, I'm going to show you how to intercept your competitors' traffic using Google Ads. And it's actually very easy, but you have to be very careful about trademarks and, you know, getting sued and all this kind of stuff. There are smart ways around it. So you might have seen these ads in the past. I think Monday.com do it really well. They say when you type in Asana, for example, it says Monday.com is so much better. So it gives you some ideas on how to intercept your competitors' traffic so that you can, you know, capture that intent and you're capturing that traffic anyway. So let's get into it. What I'm gonna do first is consider my existing campaigns and how much budget I can afford to this. So I'm looking at an existing one. It says $164 a day. I might take $20 of that and $20 of another campaign and combine it. So I've got $40 a day for this new campaign that I've got, okay? So with that said, we're going to go to the view all campaigns field, or if you're in the new setting, it's pretty much similar spot. So what we're gonna do is click overview, new campaign. Just, if you're in the new view, just click new campaign. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go to leads, because this business generates leads. We'll just go next. We'll set up that other conversions later. We'll click search. And then we'll do website visits. And then what we're gonna do is just point it to the main website that we're ranking for. So we might say here, since this is a new campaign, we might type in interception campaign, or you might wanna call it competitor campaign, competitors to simplify things, right? We already know it's a search campaign, that's cool. We won't put any target cost per action yet. Let's click next. Let's get rid of these, we don't want them. And we'll just find the areas to target. So I'm going to quickly pause and do that. Okay, so I've found the locations, and very important, I've made sure that I've clicked this one here, people in or regularly in the targeted locations. Now, since this is for a lawn treatment campaign to intercept other competitors who do lawn treatment as well, we want people who actually live in the area or around the area. And I know you could argue that people buy houses from other states and don't live in that state. That's totally cool, but we're not gonna do it for this one. Let's keep going down. I think everything else is good. Let's click next. Now it's gonna say the ad group. So we might, there's two ways to do this. You might wanna separate your competitors into different ad groups. So for example, we've got four competitors here. The only reason you might wanna do that is to make sure you got complete control of the copywriting on the actual ad, but we're not gonna do that. We're gonna bunch them all together, and we're actually gonna do a tiny bit of keyword research around these competitors to see what people are searching for when they're typing these competitors in. But in any case, we're just gonna start with the actual brand name first and add those in. So we're gonna go to keywords, I create the ad myself, make it phrase match. Okay, so we're gonna start with those four keywords to begin with. I'm not gonna go into the keyword research right this second. I just wanna illustrate how you can actually do this for yourself. So let's say that we've got those four competitors and we wanna show our ads whenever someone types in those competitors' brand names, okay? So we need to be very clever and careful with our ad. So I'm gonna come up with some variations, and I do have a video to show you how I write my ads, so go check that out. But for now, we'll pause the video and come back to it in a second. Okay, welcome back. So I've gone through all the ads and I've made sure that in the first pinning, I've got a few different options like make the switch, X brand is better. And so I've tried to make sure that this is rearranged with the pinning in a very clever way so that it's still compelling for people to have a look at. And so when this gets served in front of people typing a competitor name, at least it's compelling enough. Okay, so that's all we're trying to do. We're trying to intercept the traffic and convince them to make a switch. So once we've gone through all the checks and made sure we're happy with it, click done, and then you're pretty much good to go. What you'll need to do is click next. We'll set that budget that we both agreed on, and then we'll go next. And then competitors, okay, so everything's set up. We'll make sure that we value is required. Let's have a look. There is a value there. I don't know why it's saying that. It's saying to raise it. We're not gonna raise it, okay? So we're just going to publish it anyway and ignore Google's like prize to improve the actual budget, so that's all fine. And we'll make sure we rename that ad group, so we'll just go settings when we rename that. But that's all there is to it, right? So what's gonna happen is your ad gets served in front of your competitor's name. You're not injecting your competitor's keyword, that's a very big thing. Do not use dynamic keyword insertion only use dynamic location insertion. Very big pickup, okay? And I forgot to go through that with you. But that's pretty much it. It works the exact same way as a brand campaign, kind of, but you're intercepting your competitors' traffic instead to see whether or not that would actually have an impact on your leads. So if you've got any questions around that, let me know. Here to help, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.